Hi, Rachel Pico here with Life Abundant Ministries. I wanted to touch base with you today on something that I actually read this morning, and it just kind of jumped off the page. If you've ever had that where you're reading through God's Word and suddenly something you've read before is suddenly making a totally different appearance. It's settling not just in your brain, but on your heart. So I wanted to share that with you. It can be found in 2 Corinthians. It was all of chapter 9, but for the sake of time, I want to share with you just a few verses. In verse 6, Paul says, "Remember this, whosoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whosoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each man should give what he has decided in his heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound to you, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work." And in verse 10 it says, "Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase your store of seed and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness." Verse 11, "You will be made rich in every way, so that you can be generous on every occasion, and through us, your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God." I love that verse, that it is not just that you will be made rich in every way, it is you will be made rich in every way so that you may be generous on every occasion. And this is more of Paul writing, and he's sending a letter ahead to a church that he's about to visit, and he's letting them know, "Hey, I'm bringing some friends, and I've really talked about how generous you guys are, and I've talked about how wonderfully prepared you are, and that you're givers." And he says in verse 3 of chapter 9, in verse 3, he says, "But I'm sending the brothers in order that our boasting about you in this matter should not prove hollow, but that you may be ready as I said you would be." We need to be ready to be generous givers when God calls us to, not because we feel we have to, not because it's a grudgingly, "Oh, I guess I better do this. It's the right thing to do." But we do it out of a cheerful heart, with gladness and with excitement, knowing that God is going to return it to us. He's going to return our seed to us in a harvest that will be pressed down and shaken together and running over, so that not just for our sake, but so that we may give and that we may sow again. And I really wanted to share that with you. I hope that's uplifting to you. I hope that blesses you. If you have a chance today, go to our website. It's life-abundant.org. Check out some of the new things that we have posted. Our conference that's going to be in June is available on there. It's right on one of the banners. You can click on there and you can register today. It's going to be June 9th. So register today so that you can get your spot, because this is a free event and you want to make sure that there is place for you so that you can hear fresh from the Word of God to our hearts, to your ears. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.